Teaching doctoral students how to effectively review literature is crucial, and it involves more than just summarizing what's in the literature. Here are my lucky 13 tips for faculty and students about authoring a comprehensive literature review. Understand the purpose. Emphasize that a literature review is not just a summary, but a critical analysis of existing research. It should demonstrate the gap in the current knowledge and set the stage for their own research. Realize this. Writing a review of the literature is completely different than writing course assignments. Being good at one does not make you good at both. Know the difference. Reviewing the literature is different than writing about what's in the literature. It's not about telling what individual authors produced, it's about what does the body of knowledge mean. Organize the review. Structure the review logically, typically starting with a brief introduction and then organizing content by themes, methodologies, or chronology. Help students understand the importance of grouping related literature to highlight patterns and trends. Identify key themes and debates. Encourage students to identify common themes, trends, and debates within the literature. Ask them to critically evaluate the strengths and weaknesses of different authors and theories. Present information chronologically. Present each section chronologically. Don't go forward and backwards in time. Present content from oldest to most recent. Synthesize information. Instead of listing items separately, guide students in synthesizing information to show the progression of ideas and research. Encourage them to identify areas of agreement and disagreement amongst authors. Address methodology and limitations. Stress the importance of discussing the methodologies used in the reviewed literature and their limitations and delimitations. This will help students evaluate the overall quality of the research and its implications for their own work. Highlight gaps in the literature. Teach students to identify gaps or unresolved questions in the existing literature. Emphasize the importance of explaining how their own research will potentially contribute to filling these gaps. Use critical language. Encourage the use of critical and evaluative language rather than purely descriptive language. Discuss how to express agreement or disagreement with existing body of knowledge while providing evidence to support their stance. Be selective in inclusion. Advise students to be selective in choosing sources to include, focusing on the most relevant and influential ones. Explain the importance of covering a representative range of perspectives while avoiding unnecessary repetition. Stay updated. Remind students that the literature is dynamic and they should strive to stay updated with the latest research in their field. Encourage them to revise their literature reviews periodically to incorporate new findings. Provide clear transitions. Emphasize the importance of clear and concise transitions between different sections of the literature review. This helps readers follow the flow of ideas and understand the relationships between different authors. By incorporating these elements into your teaching, you can help students move beyond a mere summary of the literature and develop the skills to critically engage with existing research in their field. Closing point to remember. A review of the literature is like a movie. It has a story. The story is made up of intertwining pieces, ending with a clearly defined gap in the literature.